Hello dear students, this is the next module of chapter number 3 of history, in which we are discussing about that how the British they ruled over the villages. Within a few years after the new systems were introduced, it was clear that all that was not well with them. Driven by the desire to increase the income from land, revenue officials they increased the income from land. And the high revenue demands they were imposed on the peasants. Peasants were unable to pay the high revenues. That's why they fled the countryside and villages. They became deserted in many regions. The British also realized that the countryside could not only yield revenue, it could also grow the crops that Europe required. So by the late 18th century, the company was also trying to expand the cultivation of opium and indigo. In the subsequent 150 years, the British also persuaded or forced the cultivators to produce other crops like jute, tea, sugarcane, cotton, wheat and rice, which was to be supplied to Europe. The images they are showing the cotton prints. Kalamkari print that was created by weavers of Andhra Pradesh in India. A floral cotton print designed and produced by William Morris, which he was a famous poet and artist of the 19th century Britain. There is one thing common in the two prints, both use a rich blue color, commonly called indigo. So do you know how this color that was produced? The blue that you see in these prints were produced from a plant called indigo. It is likely that the blue dye used in the Morris prints in the 19th century Britain was manufactured from indigo plants cultivated in India. The tropical climate that is good for indigo cultivation. By the 13th century, Indian indigo that was in great demand in Italy, France and Britain. By the price of indigo, but the price of this indigo that was very high, and hence a small amount of Indian indigo could reach the European market. What? That was another plant which is used for making violet and the blue dyes. But what? The color that was produced by what that was pale and dull. That's why indigo that was in great demand. The indigo villages, they were usually around the indigo factories which were owned by the planters. After harvest, the indigo plant that was taken to the vats in the indigo factory. So the cultivation of indigo that also required a number of labor. And in India, the cost of labor that was very less. So dear student, this is all about this module. We shall continue the chapter with the next module. Thank you. Have a nice day.